I got really alarmed by what I saw as kind of casual Holocaust denial on Facebook through a community leader in Pittsburgh. This was in the summer of 2018, and the form that it took was the Holocaust against the Jews in Germany. So if you really are in tune with the history and you hear that, it's really disturbing, right? Because there were 600,000 Jews in Germany in 1933. So right there are so many areas where that can go wrong. I got engaged in a lot of conversations around Pittsburgh. Then in October of 2018, the attack on the Tree of Life building, right? And so this is a moment where we recognize how dangerous anti-Semitism is, how violent it is, how all of these networks exist in social media and online that law enforcement wasn't even in tune with at that point. So that's a wake-up call, not just for the Jewish community in Pittsburgh, but for the entire Pittsburgh community. So that's the other side of this. People who felt like they belonged in the Squirrel Hill neighborhood then felt like they might be targeted. And of course, they have been targeted. When we talk about members of the government now feeling like they're being threatened, well, now they know what it feels like for most of the Jewish community. And yes, anti-Semitism is connected to all of these other forms of bigotry, racism, xenophobia, misogyny, et cetera. Now, our government understands, you know, they have also felt comfortable because other people are being targeted, right? So, if I can bring us back to this question of Holocaust testimony, what can we learn from it? While all of these things are going on around us, how does it contribute to our understanding of the situation in which we all find ourselves right now?
We have to understand that, no historical event is obviously the same as another historical event, but I think we do ourselves a disservice, and the survivors actually a disservice, if we don't allow the space for making sort of critically grounded comparisons. Because, if you look at survivors' testimonies themselves, they talk about, they make the comparisons explicitly in their testimonies. Testimonies are recorded in the 70s and the 80s and the 90s. They talk about current events, and they themselves see current events through the eye, through their own eyes, and through the sort of lens of what they experienced in Europe during the Second World War. And so I think we need that to help us understand what's happening around us today. To use their stories as at least, at the very least, a warning about what potentially can happen in the future. And so I think that listening to survivors, and survivors are not a monolithic group, so some would oppose any sort of idea of a comparison, whereas others would embrace it because they find it intellectually useful. And I think that I would prefer to err on the side of the latter and use their stories as a sort of launching point for to warn our current society about what is possible in the future.